मिस्टर वाइस चेयरमैन सर, आई एम ऑब्लाइज्ड टू द हाउस फॉर द जनरल सपोर्ट दिस मेजर हैज रिसीव्ड. आई वुड लाइक टू क्लियर अप वन आर टू पॉइंट्स. आई वुड बिगिन बाय सेइंग दैट दिस एक्ट व्हेन इट वाज पास्ड एंड एज इट स्टैंड्स टुडे ऑन द स्टैट्यू बुक is intended only to regulate and control industries. Its purpose is not to take over the ownership of industries. For that, we have got other measures and other methods to follow. The limited purpose here is this. Wherever industries appear to be going wrong and wherever because of the mismanagement or bad management, public interest is affected or production has gone down, in such cases there is provision for government to take them over for a period and manage them. Now, it has been found in many cases that we have taken over and managed them and managed them well. I would like to point out that there are many very good examples where industries which a little while ago were going down have prospered under government management and control, and in this period the government has never used its power indiscriminately. In all these years, 12 undertakings were taken over and then handed back. 7 undertakings are today under the management of the government. One of the undertakings which is today under government management and which has occasioned this measure was in a rather bad way when government took it over about 7 years ago, and the government within the initial 5-year period of management improved its finances. Its profits have gone up. Its reserves have gone up. The concern has considerably improved, but then it was again thought that it has to be continued under proper management, and government are of the opinion that this management has to continue. If the existing law remains as it is today, there is no course open to the government but to hand it back to the shareholders. This is one of the reasons why this measure has been brought forward before this house, because the law as it stands today does not permit more than one extension of such management. So I think that clears the point which was raised by some of my friends. There is nothing like unlimited extension. This is act is not meant for government to virtually take over industries and continue indefinitely in control of them. I am in sympathy with some of the views expressed. It is true that we should take responsibilities which we should be able to discharge well, and I think even the most critical members will be satisfied that we have taken such responsibilities very selectively and discharge them well. It may be that there are certain concerns which were really beyond redemption, but we have been making a sort of effort, and that effort is well worth it. Now take the case of India Electric Works. Even as a working concern, it is still in bad shape. The government were compelled to take it over because otherwise it had to close down and a large number of workers were to be thrown out of employment. That was one of the reasons why we took it over. But then we cannot go on taking indefinitely such responsibilities at the cost of the taxpayer money. There is a limit to it. And what is the limit to such cases? My only intention is that to the best of its capacity, whatever is possible, the government should try to bring about improvements, and this provision of one extension alone should not stand in the way. Therefore, the amending bill gives powers to the government to extend control by periods of 2 years at a time, but by not more than 10 years in all after the expiry of the initial period of 5 years. In that period, it is supposed that the concern would be set in order. That is the intention. I am sure that this amendment will be helpful both to the private industry as well as to whatever the government does in such cases. It is desirable in every way. The honorable member referred to various companies which were mismanaged. I know of many cases, but my own and the government's policy is that they should take responsibility in such matters after careful scrutiny and examination. And that meets the point raised by some other friends too. We should not take over such responsibilities indiscriminately. We are careful, and once a responsibility is taken, the intention is to perform it well. That is why it is not possible to take over many more concerns. Yet it may be desirable, despite the limitations of the government, to take over the control and management of concerns in the country's interests, and where the public interest is involved, the government cannot simply plead that its hands are full. We cannot shirk that responsibility when public interest is involved. I can assure the House that we shall not hesitate to serve the public interest.